Threatening a salmon fishery industry, not only for indigenous peoples, but also for the sports fisheries, also for the ecotourism and many other parts of our economy that really depend on wild salmon. And this fish farm industry is posing a real danger to bring our wild salmon to extinction, and it must be stopped.
Have you been in touch with the First Nations that are occupying those farms?
Yes, I've been in touch with them. As a matter of fact, we have Willie Moon here. We have Bob Chamberlain. Willie Moon is a traditional chief and leader of the Wiskamot Wadena people, and Bob Chamberlain is the president of the Fraser River First Nations Alliance. And we also have a lot of First Nations in along the river who are in solidarity with the Wiskamot Wadena people to get the fish farms out of their territory. But we also know that this is not an indigenous issue. This is an issue that all British Columbians, all Canadians really need to pay attention to and to support, because fish, our wild salmon is a climate regulator. And if we see the smoke and we see the fires that have been going on right now, we know how important it is for the salmon to continue to come back in large numbers so they can feed the forests that nurture life, absorbs carbon from the atmosphere and provides us with the oxygen we need to breathe. So if the wild salmon disappear, there's going to be an ecological collapse, a real unraveling that must be stopped. One measure to do this is to remove those open net pen fish farms from the migration routes of our wild salmon. That's essential.
Yes.
What's been the latest on the occupation? What has developed in the last couple of days here?
There is a commitment. We have Willie Moon here who is going to speak to that. But they're here to stay. They are determined to continue to occupy those fish farms until the province has taken up the political will that they have. They have the jurisdiction not to renew the licenses of occupation of fish farms. And once they're able to do that, once they exercise that political will to do it, then those fish farms will have to be removed. We have Willie here as well. He's an excellent spokesperson for the Wiskamot Wadena.
Special Legislative Committee on Sustainable Agriculture, and force this industry to evolve just as every other resource industry has. It's time for this fish farm industry to become closed containment land-based. And we've had Chief Willie Moon and I, we met yesterday with Premier Horgan, and we talked with Minister Fraser and Minister Popham. And they've committed to come and meet with us to discuss this, and I look forward to that engagement. And what we have in the territories of the Wiskamot people is absolute unity. We have addressed our overlapping claims. We are in unity as community, hereditary leadership, and elected leadership. And so when this government wants to begin the embracing of the UN Declaration of the Rights of Indigenous People, free, prior, and informed consent, we have a very clear message that has spanned three decades. It has not wavered in any way, shape, or form. And this letter that I referenced from the First Nation Wild Salmon Alliance, signed by over half the First Nations of British Columbia, I will be presenting this later today to Premier Horgan at the Leadership Council press conference. And so we got a very clear message, and I think that the good people of British Columbia need to understand the vast majority of First Nations of British Columbia are absolutely opposed to open net cage fish farms. I would dare to say that 90% of the First Nations are in opposition. And so this is something that the governments need to understand. And lastly, what I want to do is just list off a number of the nations that have signed this. We have the Stauber First Nation that have signed this. We have the Inukjuaq Nation. We have the Shkatlion people of the Okanagan Nation Alliance with the Shuswap Tribal Council, the Haida Nation, the Gitxsan, the Wet'suwet'en. We have the Carrier Secondi people. I'm talking about the vast majority of First Nations of British Columbia that rely upon wild salmon, and it is beyond comprehension that the government does not embrace the full value of healthy and abundant wild salmon stocks. You can hear behind us our brothers from the Stauber sharing some of their songs. And there is a large group of First Nation chiefs in this crowd today standing to support their signatures, and so British Columbians can understand that the protection of wild salmon is paramount to all First Nations of British Columbia.
Can you just reiterate the significance of that document?
And if you could flip through the pages again, just to remember.
So this letter from the First Nation Wild Salmon Alliance, it requests First Nation leaders to sign in support of the occupation of the fish farms. It calls on the government to embrace meaningfully the science that has been established. It calls on the government to embrace the Cohen Commission. It calls on the government to embrace the Special Legislative Committee on Sustainable Aquaculture. And it calls on the government to have this industry evolve, as every other industry has, to be land-based closed containment. What people do not understand about the fish farm industry when they say that they are a profitable industry is because they can externalize 90% of their waste costs into the environment on a daily basis. As you can see as I flip through these pages, there are many First Nation leaders that are standing up and saying it is incomprehensible that the government does not take the adequate steps to protect the wild salmon. The great honor and privilege of have leadership from across this province of British Columbia that have signed the document to support the removal of open net cage fish farms from the ocean. First Nations of British Columbia is demanding that this industry evolve to closed containment land-based so we can remove the threat to wild salmon. And it is a sad day when we have to do this to remind the provincial and federal government of just how important wild salmon is to our people, to British Columbians, to the economy, to the environment. It is an undeniable fact about First Nations' reliance upon wild salmon. It is constitutionally protected. It is recognized as a right from the Supreme Court of Canada. And it is now the time when First Nations are standing united to ensure the voice is clear and concise, that we look after the wild salmon that has sustained our people since the beginning of time. With this provincial government's embracing of the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous People, half the First Nations of British Columbia have signed this document supporting this. This is what free, prior, and informed consent is going to look like, so that we have a food source, a sacred food source, that is looked after for all British Columbians, not First Nations alone, but to ensure that our people can sustain themselves as they have since the beginning of time.
and no longer allow the open net cage fish farms to externalize all the waste of their industry into the environment, to impact the salmon, to impact the herring, to impact the cod, to impact the clams. It is now time that the governments wake up and support wild salmon, period.
First of all, I want to acknowledge the Tsleil-Waututh, Squamish, and Musqueam, and I want to commend and congratulate all of you for once again coming together from all corners of the province, from up and down the coast, from the interior, and once again raising our voices and serving notice on the governments of this land of Canada and the province of British Columbia, that we have every right, we have a fundamental human right to protect the pristine waters of the coast of one of the most beautiful places on the planet. We have every right to protect the waters of our river systems and the livelihoods and the way of life that it has provided for Indigenous peoples, as well as our dear friends and neighbors in various capacities of the sports fishery, commercial fishery, recreation, and the multi-billion dollar tourism trade in British Columbia. There's a reason that this is the most beautiful place on the planet.
Yeah.
Because of the blessings from our Creator that manifest themselves in this beautiful province. And we cannot afford, will not accept, and will not tolerate the continued contamination and desecration of our marine ecosystems with the toxic fish farm industry as it exists today. Yeah, and on behalf of the Union of BC Indian Chiefs and our friends and allies, we want to congratulate Chief Willie Moon and others that have actually occupied two of the fish farms. We are so grateful for their courage, for their sense of integrity, and for bringing this to the public's attention once more in one of the most effective ways that we know, and that's to occupy the territory, occupy the space, and take action. Talking is over. I want to particularly express my gratitude for my dear friend and colleague, Chief Bob Chamberlain. Most of you here know that he's been giving voice to protect our iconic wild salmon for as long as I've known Chief Chamberlain. And at long last, he is not standing alone, that other people have come together as we have in the past, as we will continue to do in the future, regardless of whether it's the toxic fish farm industry or Kinder Morgan. We have a duty and an obligation to protect the legacy that was handed to us by our ancestors and those that came before us. And we have a duty and an obligation to pass this on to our children and grandchildren in an undiminished state. And as British Columbians, as Canadians, as Indigenous peoples, that's a very sacred duty we carry. And I'm so grateful that you're all here and you know and understand that. And we will continue to work together until those fish farms are on land where they belong. By Lim Lim.
Salmon people. Firstly, I want to thank our brothers and sisters of the Squamish, Tsleil-Waututh, and Musqueam for allowing us to be on their territory, their beautiful territory with this great river with the great salmon runs that we want to maintain, we want to build up again. I want to thank you all for coming to show your support and just to demonstrate to the world that this is more than just a First Nations issue. This is a global issue. This is for all of us.
That's right.
In protecting our environment. We all know how critical salmon are, not only for nutrition for us, but what we've discovered, how it does look after the forests, look after the animals.
Right.
I see a sign here, a keystone species. Absolutely true. I want to thank the people for coming again. I want to thank all the time. I thank the previous speaker for reminding us that there was enough time for talk. We've talked long enough. It's time for action. There's action happening now. And I want to remind us that within our action, we always want to be respectful too, because that's in our tradition. I know we all share these same traditions and same teachings. You know, we're occupying a farm in our territory. We're doing it very respectfully. And we intend, we're not going to stop that occupation until that farm goes away. Sure. And I know with your support, that boys are our ability to do that. So I want to thank you all again for being here. And let's just, we're heading in the right direction now. We have to keep going in that direction till all these farms are on land. They're no longer polluting our ocean. Gaelic Kessler.
I'd just like to say something. All these young people have stepped up and they're occupying it, and it's the young people that are pushing us to do that, and that's why we're here, to save the salmon. And I'm so proud of those young people. So proud. Gotta save them. Get the farms out.
Willie Moon, to come and share a few words. And I invite our Muskemaug Tsaudino hereditary chiefs and the hereditary chiefs that are here to come and stand in support.
First of all, good afternoon, and I'd like to say it's nice to see some of the faces from last year. As you all recall, we were down here last year linking arms with the other nations. And it's so sad that we have to come back a year later and we're still fighting the fight that we have been doing for the past 30 years. And, you know, it's getting to the point now where if we don't get these fish farms out of our territory, we will never be able to recover in getting our salmon back into our waters. So today I just want to say to our boys that are out on the farm right now, I'm very proud of them, and we will continue this fight, and we will take it till the governments start to listen to us. We've had meetings today and yesterday, and some of the words I've heard sound very promising, but words are words, action is action, so that's what we're looking for in this next few months. I know we do have a meeting scheduled with the minister or the premier on the North Island. We haven't set a date yet, but we will. And I'm hoping that they will take what we're saying seriously. Get these fish farms out of the water and back on land. So once again, I want to say thank you to Eddie. I don't see him, but
behind you.
Thank you for all the work and support that you have shown the Muskemaug Tsaudinuk people. And it's an honor to come and stand with you, my friend. And so I need to ask is just that all of you remember and keep our warriors in your prayers while we occupy the fish farms. Gaelic Kessler.
This wonderful day, I see that on the media that chickens have rights. People get arrested for abusing chickens.
It's true.
So our salmon have rights.
That's right. We're salmon.
Stop abusing our salmon. Let's arrest a few people. Thank you for coming today.
Put his heart in the right place, continuously to look after wild salmon, my brother Eddie Gardner.
Ossiamsiaya, Yatukwasai, Tithwalam, Yahiamit, Tamoks, Slilwatuth, Musqueam, cast Squamish. Welcome, We're so good to be here on the territory of the Squamish, Tsleil-Waututh, and Musqueam people. It's an honor for me to come here and see all of you show up and send a message to the federal government and the provincial government that the time of action is now. The federal government, Minister Dominic LeBlanc, Justin Trudeau, John Horgan, Lana Pafan, you guys move your butts and get over to the fish farms and speak with those people who are occupying the fish farms and listen to them.
Yes.
Open your eyes to the reality that fish farms are harming the wild salmon, the herring, the clam beds, and they're fouling the marine environment. And this must come to an end.
Yeah.
It only takes the political will for the province to finally step forward as a new government, the NDP government, to say, let's make history. Let's cleanse the waters of open net pen fish farms and give our wild salmon a chance to come back in the higher numbers that we need. Thank you. And make no mistake, we're not gonna stop until the fish farms are out. Make no mistake, this is the time of action and we've got to get the job done before it's too late. Can you imagine beautiful British Columbia without wild salmon? That would be an absolute catastrophe, an ecological disaster, and a great, great harm to the wild salmon economy here. We as Wilmot people consider the salmon as our relatives. So do the people down in all along the coast and all along the river. They are our relatives. That's how deeply we feel about them. So that's what connects us. The wild salmon is the great connector. It connects all of us. It connects all of our relatives in the natural world. That's why we must save wild salmon. And we need to heed that message that wild salmon must stand forever. Without wild salmon, if the wild salmon go, it means the unraveling of an ecosystem that is so dear to us and upon which we all depend as human beings. And all the we're not the only ones who depend on wild salmon either, and everybody knows that. But the open net pen fish farms are destroying that wild salmon. So thank you, from the bottom of my heart, thank each and every one of you for standing up today. My message to you now is to write those letters, sign those petitions, get out there and send those messages, phone the Prime Minister, phone Dominic LeBlanc, phone Lana Pafan, phone all those people who have the power that it takes to remove the fish farms so that we can have a powerful collective movement that can make history and get this doggone job done. Hoosier.
Thank you. My name is Michelle Oderts. I'm the chief of the Shekelwash and Kikaitan community in the Stadtlium Nation. We're located on the Fraser River. And when we talk about these fish farms, the reason it impacts us upstream is because the Fraser salmon sockeye are going right by these and we're seeing them deplete. And it's not good. It's very sad what is being created up in the rivers, what we're losing, what we're all losing. In my community, we have three spawning channels. So we're home to the fish, this gift that was given to us. We're making sure that they have a home to come to. We don't even fish these salmon. They're coming there because we're looking after their home. We're greeting them. They're there to feed the bears, the eagles, the bugs, the land, the very gift that was given to all of us, every one of us. and asked Chief Bob to let me speak because I needed to let everybody know that these salmon that are being penned up, these salmon that have no purpose to the gifts that were given to us. I can't understand what these salmon are actually feeling in a caged up pen when they actually can't actually live out the purpose that they were given to by the Creator. They have nowhere to go. They're just swimming around aimlessly. I thought, where are these Atlantic salmon going out there that escaped? They're probably swimming around out there wondering, where am I supposed to go? Where's my home? Who am I supposed to be mating with? How many babies am I supposed to have? They can't even do that. That is what they were there for. That is why the Creator gifted them to us. Our stocks are depleting so drastically. You know that the fighting is going to start going on. For me, I have to be a voice for the animals. I have to be a voice for the land. I have to be a voice for the fish. Because without them, we start losing everything. We start losing what our fight is all about, who we are as people, what we're supposed to be teaching our children. We can't do that right now. We can't. We can go down there and we can be by the river. We can listen to the water. We can see the fish jumping through these falls. Is that something that they're supposed to do? But we can't put our nets in the water. We can't fish them. And that's what's happening to the sockeye that are swimming through these pens. And they need to get out. They need to really look at our way of life, everybody's way of life. You know, we don't look after the spawning channels for the commercial fishermen. They've never come up and said, thank you, Chief, for looking after our fish. We're looking after their investment in a way, but we're looking after it because it feeds the bears that come to our spawning channel to feed on them. And that's how people need to start looking at it. We're looking after an investment. They need to come and give back. They need to come back and drop tobacco and make an offering and say, thank you for doing this for us. But nobody's doing that. I need to go up north to the Chilcoot, to the Quesnel River and say thank you for looking after the fish that we catch, because that is the run. We need to educate ourselves on the complexity of the salmon and who they are and what they do for us, because then we will start respecting that journey that is the most sacred journey of any journey that is out there. And that is how I feel about them. And that is what I fight for. So I just want to thank you all for the opportunity to come and share a little bit of how I feel and what we do in my community for the salmon, the gift that was given to us by the Creator. So, Kukshtem. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you. Talitul quas to Ailis. A chapter squaw well quills quits lala teethalopsit CMCIS. My English name is Ralph Leon, chief of the Ailis people. I'm glad to stand here hand in hand with all of your leadership here with our grand chiefs. I'm glad to stand in line with them, with you. To protect something that has sustained all of us since the beginning of life here. We're the people of the river. We held that to the highest. And our elders were saying, if you was to take our DNA, we're probably 90% First Nation and 10% salmon. That's who we are. We're the people of the land. And it's going to take all of us to stand together as a people. In our language, there is no words for blue eyes, blonde hair. There is no words. In our language, it's Sitalops, it's Wilmuk. We're all brothers and sisters, regardless where we come from. We need to stand together, hand in hand, to protect what is here. It is ours. It belongs to the people of the river and of BC, Canada. We have a great opportunity with new government that was here. Your leadership, we prepared ourselves for them. I only wish you guys were here a couple days ago, or yesterday, or this morning. That's when some of the government bodies that were here that to need to hear what you're saying, what we're saying together as a people. I love and cherish who I am, and I know you do too. The salmon is one of our prized resource, natural resources, besides our children. And that's why we're here. As Uncle Stewart said, we need to look into the eyes, through the children's eyes, for the future. Not so truthful, so true. We're here for the future. You know, our elders say sometimes it's okay to be wealthy, but not at the expense of our natural resources. Not at the expense of our people. Our hospitals, our cancer society facilities are filled with people, our people. Was something that, you know, we never wish upon anybody, cancers. You know, just on the weekend we were fishing, one of our members up the Fraser Valley, they caught one of those fish that got out. They caught one. It's not good. Not good for our people. Not good for the Fraser River. Not good for the salmon. I think we should be done just talking. We need to move forward. We need to go to them and tell them, hand in hand. That's what we need to do. All your leaders are here together, hand in hand, talking about our homes. This is our home, Tsleil-Waututh, the Tsleil-Waututh, where all our teachings come from, the land, the water. And I'm very proud to have been here for the last couple days with all the beautiful leaders, speaking the truth, speaking from here. This is our other mind, where our ancestors, our elders, filled us with all the beautiful knowledge to survive off the land. That's where they're speaking from. For you, regardless who is here, it's for all of you. Hey, Chap, Disquel, Wilquil, Quetzlala, CM, Asiaya, OCM.
OCM.
CM, this Olquan. CM, this Iaya. Heights, Abka. Quetzi, Tap, me, Tatel, Nomit, Tinequel. Nots, Anuts, Ayath, Nomit. Antha, Quolfitston. To Tani Tana Tina Salsitla, to Tani Joseph, to Tani Stamanis, my dear elders, family who are here today, I thank each and every one of you for the work that you're doing here today. What precious work this is today that you are here for. 2017, that is when it changed, when a group of people came together and they ended those fish farms here in BC. We are at a critical point in our history. You look all around us, the climate is changing. You look at the forest fires that we haven't seen before. You look at the depleting stocks of our wild salmon. Something is screaming out to us, it has to change. That BC and Department of Fisheries and Oceans is mismanaging this precious resource for all of us. And if they can do it, and I think you've seen it yourself here today, it's we, the First Nations, we will be responsible for it if government can't. Time has shown that their policies, their mechanisms to keep the fish in the pen don't work. They don't keep them in the pen. I think it's time that the BC government and Department of Fisheries and Oceans puts an end to this and begins to look at our wild salmon. You look at their numbers that they give each of us every year for the salmon that we can get. Their numbers that they tell us that we can get. Time of talking is done. And I thank you for getting out there because it's time for action. Wherever your community is, talk to your family, talk to your community. Get them out there, get them involved because we need your help. Write the letters, talk to your MLA, talk to your MP, do whatever it is within your power that you can do because it makes a difference. You're here today, it makes a difference. We can do this together, my friends. No fish farms here. Join me. No fish farms here.
Chief Don Tom, we're from the Swiss Saitnich Nation from the southern part of Vancouver Island. And it is a huge threat to wild salmon. And there's a lot of science that proves against that. Like, the threat to our salmon, it's again, one of our natural resources for us and for our people, and it's maintained our health. And for the future, looks like it's getting more depleted. And if there's any more promotion of fish farms, I can't even support that. I want the government now to take the action and hear all the people. I'm glad everyone's out here, and this is a serious issue. And again, when we're talking about a lot of the deformities, a lot of the diseases that they have, the threat to our wild salmon, any of them even joining some of the wild salmon and getting near them is going to cause a lot of those because they don't have the immunity systems that they have built up with the fish farms and the antibiotics and things that they're giving them to maintain them in their fish pens. And when they're getting out, those kind of diseases can spread because our wild salmon is not exposed to those kind of diseases. And so that's why it's a huge threat. And when everything I say today is like, we're always looking for the next seven generations. The decisions that we make today will impact our future. And our future children need wild salmon, just like the rest of us. Thank you.
Yarik Shinwenwen, Aaron Salmon Shquesht. I'm here with some other Ntlagatmuk people here. We would like to acknowledge the Coast Salish people whose territory that we're on today. Yeah, my name's Aaron Sam, and I'm chief of the Lower Nicolet Indian Band. I'd like to thank Eddie Gardner for organizing this and getting everybody here today. You know, this is an important issue. We come from the interior, but as everybody here knows, you know, the salmon, it's just not a coastal issue, it's not an island issue. It's an issue for all British Columbians, all Canadians, internationally. And the time of, we've heard it already by many, many eloquent speakers before me, but the time for action is now. We need to learn from the lessons of Canada's East Coast. Our children, our grandchildren, our great-grandchildren, their future, it will be directly affected by what we do today. My grandmother and my mother have told me the stories of when living in the interior on the Thompson and the Fraser, where when the fish come up, there would be ribbons of red on the side coming up into our territory. And I believe prior to that, 150 years ago or 200 years ago or even farther back, we had rivers of red in the summer months. So, you know, the time of action is now. We have to work together. it's not just for Indigenous people, it's not just for British Columbians or Canadians, it's for all of us. And, you know, I just want to thank everybody for being here. I'm going to pass the mic to my my relative here, Chief Lee Spahan. And, yeah, thank you for being here. Homa.
Cookstown, Aaron. My name's Lee Spahan, Chief of the Coldwater Indian Band. All I have to say, no fish farms. Yeah. No fish farms. They gotta be land-based. Yeah. Cookstown, thank you.
Morgan from Mathqui First Nation. I welcome everybody. We have a small community that sits on the Fraser River. I'm a grandmother of seven. I'm the sole fisherman for my family. I know what it feels like to be on the water. I know what it does to bring our families together when we're on the water. When me and my boys get on our boat at 4 o'clock in the morning to go gather food, it feels good. It feels good to watch my grandchildren dive into that bowl of fish and rice. It feels good. And I'm here today to say no to open pen fish farms. I'm also here to say, where do I sign? Because I'm not sure Mathqui First Nation has signed yet, so where do we sign? Thank you very much.
Recently, I saw a film on salmon coming up the rivers, and this film it documented just 120-pound salmon. I mean, we're talking just waves of it coming up the river, and they caught a few, and the salmon were this tall. I've never thought that salmon got this big before, and I'm 67 years old. And somebody said there was such a thing as 120-pound salmon, I would have said, I don't think so. But now I know. I saw the film, I saw the reality. And it's amazing that there's been past injustices done to us. And you have no idea that these injustices have been done until you see this film. And so we need to reconciliate that. We need justice to bring back these 120-pound salmon for our children. This is seven generations ago, there was these fish in our rivers. There was, as a person that was born here, lived in the North Vancouver and East Vancouver, I can tell you that it's amazing what I know as a kid. These situations now have disappeared. We need to bring back at least some parts of them to represent the past. The lifeblood of this province is our salmon. It's just the word reconciliation of describing what are the past injustices were, getting down, feeling them, and then correcting them, and then and bringing justice back. And we can go to the moon, and we should be able to bring back 120 pound salmon to our coast and bring back the way it was 120 years ago. It's possible. That's it.
Thank you very much, Rod. When those people, the Musquamaw, the Wadenoc, and their allies stepped onto the fish farms, that was the signal, my friends. Business as usual is ending, and we're going to get those fish farms out of the water. I, for one, have been mobilizing people to support this effort for the past some 10 years. Things have been mobilizing. We've come to this point in our history where the moment of opportunity is now. We can make history. We've been sending money to the Musquamaw, Tsleil-Waututh people to help them in their cause. We've been supporting them politically, socially, morally, and we're going to continue to do that. I, for one, I'm going to go to the fish farms and where they're being occupied right now, and I'm going to stand with them and I'm going to say, yes, you have much support. There's a groundswell of support from Indigenous and non-Indigenous peoples across British Columbia. It's growing across Canada. It's penetrating into the United States. And we have many supporters who are supporting it internationally in Scotland and other places. So we're not alone. We're not alone in this. My hands go up to each and every one of you, thanking you from the bottom of my heart for answering the call to action to save our wild salmon. Oceán, yakukusai.
Rod Marinetti, pretty badass kind of guy, right? So anyways, he's got some amazing stories, so if you can get him in a corner. I would like to invite Sasheen. She's one of the warriors that stopped fish farming in her traditional territory before the fish got in. So if you want to hear some amazing stories on how to live with courage, Sasheen.
I'd like to welcome you all here to my territory as a woman who has roots here in Musqueam. So I thank you for coming out to our territory here today to prove not only just protest, but to protect wild salmon, to defend wild salmon. I would like to say is that almost 2 years ago now, we were the first ever people from the Ahouset Nation on the west coast of Vancouver Island who occupied a fish farm and stopped salmon from actually coming in after a permit was put out there. Never happened before on the planet until that time. We called ourselves the Yaksuis Warriors because it was in the Yaksuis Channel. And we lived on that fish farm for 2 weeks. And I'm so grateful to all of the people who supported us while we did that. It took a lot of courage and a lot of help from the people in the village, and our chiefs were against us. The hereditary chiefs at the end finally came and said, okay, we won't let them put a fish farm here. But they didn't say anything about moving the already existing 16 farms in those waters that belong to the Ahouset Nation. So we really have a lot of work left to do on the West Coast. There's a lot of Tsleil-Waututh warriors out there, our neighboring nations, and our cousins and our family who are doing a lot of work right now to put a stop to fish farms. And that's amazing. But what I really want to share is that it's really good to have our hereditary and elected leadership from other nations stand up and show the Ahouset leadership what it's really like to protect wild salmon, because what they are doing and allowing is shameful. And as a matriarch and as a mother and a grandmother, it is my duty to protect our wild salmon. That is the first food that was ever fed to my children as babies, the first food that we fed to my grandchildren. And it is a food that we have, but it's also a relative, and that's beautiful. And we have an agreement to take care of these salmon and to put their bones back in the water when we are done so that they can replenish themselves, they can come back, they know their ancestors are there, and they know that we take care of them. I can't begin to describe what it's like right now to be a defender of the land and a protector of the water, but also as a mother and a grandmother, to see what's happening to our waters, our worst nightmares, has come true when these Atlantic salmon escaped. And as was mentioned before, they have spirits and they don't know where they are and what they are doing. And it reminds me of white society. They don't know where they are and what they're doing. And they're lost. And so, as the people of these lands and these waters, it's our duty to show them the way, because we know what we have to do to protect the salmon, the bears, everything that lives in the ocean and on the land. That's our duty, to show people respect for the land. It's not all just for profit, it's to sustain us for the future, for my grandchildren's grandchildren, so that they can have their first foods as wild salmon, as clams, as broths from the ocean, the foods that feed us and sustain us and give us healthy brains and minds, healthy bones. Salmon is a beautiful and unique creature. And what is happening is very intense and scary, and we have to just stop asking people like Scott Fraser to protect these salmon or to make moves in the government to do something, because they're not going to. You heard his words. We have no time for patience. Sorry, Scott. There's no room for your patience. There's no room for bureaucracy and paperwork. There's no room to spend the next 10 years in litigation. It must be now. And what is happening on these farms with these occupations brings me so much joy. I have a lot of personal things going on right now, and I can't be involved as I want to. My husband is in the hospital, but his love of wild salmon is what brought me here today. Away from caring for him, because I knew that he would want me to be here. He would want our children to be here. And he would want the world to know we have to now fight. And we have to support those who are fighting, whatever that looks like. Regardless of how we personally feel about what a fight is, because we are literally fighting for the life of not only the salmon, but for us as First Nations people and the people who came here on our lands and settled. Because this is a species that if it goes, we go with it. And it's the ultimate importance. And we have grave concerns, as mentioned here today. It's time to now just stand up and do what is right, regardless of how the government and the police make us feel or look. We have to be brave and determined and have discipline in the face of the fire and do what needs to be done, because if we don't, we are doing a disservice to the ancestors, we are doing a disservice to the future, our children's grandchildren. So we must, at this point, do whatever we can and whatever it takes to stop these fish farms from operating in our waters.
I'd like to start by saying Heads Up to each person who came today, who's still here, to every nation, especially our brother and sister nations here. Natsamast, we are one. The words mean nothing until we turn it into action, and we have a woman standing right here who knows what that action looks like, that Sasheen stood with so many people and occupied for those 2 weeks, 2 years ago, and it made a difference. So as a person who loves words, it may shock some of you to hear me say that the time for words is over. The time for action is now. Whose laws are we going to follow? The laws of the people, the laws of the land, or the laws of the genocidal colonial government that is still not just killing us, but killing everything we need to live on. We know what's wrong. We know what is evil. What are we going to counter it with? What steps are you going to take? What are you going to do in your everyday life? How are you going to support the people next to you? How are we going to support our fishermen and our fisherwomen who are in the commercial industry, who need to continue to make a living, who have families to support? How are we going to support the bears and the eagles that are already going hungry? In my community in Musqueam, we have had no fish distribution for 3-4 years now. I just came back from almost a month in Haida Gwaii. No fish distribution there either. I watch those lodge fishermen, it's predominantly middle-aged and retired white men up there in the lodges, leaving with boxes and boxes of salmon that the people in Haida Gwaii, the people from that land, in that land, aren't getting. It's time to call a spade a spade. It's time to put the people first, and not just the people who can afford to pay for what they call a resource, but the people who have actually cared for the land since the first sunrise. We need to follow the laws of the people of the land. We have beautiful examples of what that looks like everywhere. We saw a stellar example of what is possible at Standing Rock. We saw a stellar example of what is possible with the occupation Sachin was involved in 2 years ago. We have examples all around us of what we can do. So I love rallies. I love when we get together and we drum and we sing and we get to speak and we get to actually hear where each other are from when we open our hearts and our minds and we set a plan together. But what is the plan moving forward from right now? What's the action that's going to follow this? I know what my actions are. Do you know what yours are? I don't put that down as a challenge. I put that down as a reality. The reality is that we have no more time for patience. I do not want a white male politician who's benefiting from the genocide of my people and our fish to tell me that I need to have more patience. I'm sure as a human being, he's a very decent person, but you can't stand here in front of a bunch of Indians who have been going without for over 500 years and tell us we need more patience. Because apathy, being idle, and being silent, we saw where that gets us with Hitler. People are wondering what's going to happen with Trump. Same direction, people. It's terrifying. So we band together. We bring the light and the love. I would like to say we only bring the peace, but I'm sure that that's not going to be possible. So we put our best warriors in the front. And we put our most vulnerable in the middle. And we watch how nature protects. We watch how nature defends. And we do the same thing. We step up or we step back, because there's no more time for complacency and there's no more time for, well, let me think about it and let's put some paperwork together and let's have a meeting about it. Excuse my language, but fuck your meetings and fuck your patience. I have no more time for it. So we still have to do things in a good way, though. Yes, we are enraged and it is justifiable rage, but what are we going to do with it? What we do, we have to look back and be proud of. What we say has to still honor who we come from. Now, we come from proud people, all of us here. We're lucky we get to be on the land that our ancestors are from and the land that our ancestors are still in. I implore you, do what would make your ancestors proud. Follow who your ancestors are. Connect with how your ancestors lived and move forward from there. So recognize that all of the momentum that we've put together today, we have to move forward into action with. I'm not following politicians. I'm not waiting for permission, because this right here, this is my ancestors' land. I have their permission, and that's what I'm gonna move forward with. Haitsapka.
Thank you. Oh. Yeah.